So I'm going to ask Diana to introduce her.
So is this one that I have to?
Yes, that's right.
Okay.
Just
okay. Thank you, Thomas, for the invitation, for the organization, for that. So I'm going to tell you what I do, how I conceive the concept of co-production, and also I'm going to explain the methods that I use for emergency response after earthquakes and recovery after earthquakes, and how the concept of co-production is embedded in them. And at the end, I'm going to do a co-production exercise with your support. Although most people have or use a social media platform, at least one, and when there is an event like an earthquake, this social media platform explodes with images and posts about search and rescue activities, damages, ethnic information, emergency actions, arrival of humanitarian aid, solidarity messages, solidarity actions, and at least for me, this is a very co-production of data with the users. Now, what I do is, when there is an earthquake, for instance, the 2018 earthquake, I follow the hashtag of the earthquake during a specific period, and I collect the data, mainly from Twitter, now Instagram, now X, sometimes Instagram or Facebook when it contains links to other social media platforms. As I said before, this is for me co-production. Since 2021, we are also getting data from the European Mediterranean Seismological Center, who developed the Last Quake app. It's an app that I invite you to download, on which users report the intensity that they felt when there is an earthquake, and they, some of them also submit upload images and text data. So, Last Quake app is part of a crowdfunding platform, so that for me it's a very also co-production. And what I do is, with the image data, I locate the damaged building. This is for the case of Zagreb. But then my question, okay, I can't locate building damaged, but what to do with the text data? Then I went to the literature, academic literature, and I found that some authors were using sentiment and topic models. Sentiment and topic modeling for analyzed data collected during emergency response. This is for the case of Hurricane Sandy and all. Now, for those who doesn't know, data collected through social media is a structure. This is what you get. Then you need to use natural language processing techniques like sentiment analysis, on which the data is classified according to the polarity, positive, negative, and relative. I use this technique because it's a technique used in customer review, on which the customer can say what they like or why they not, and I consider that at least for emergency response and recovery, these are services provided by governments, and the citizens have the right to express the dissatisfaction or dissatisfaction with them. There is another technique that is topic analysis, on which the text data is classified to a list of topics, no polarities. And what I do is, with any case, in any cases, after data is collected and processed, I classify the data according to the polarity for sentiment analysis and according to topic for topic analysis. Now, I do the same with data from the EMC. And the rules, these are the rules for the classification into positive, negative, and neutral. Just to summarize, everything that reduces the impact of the earthquake and make easy the recovery is considered positive. Everything that increases the impact of the earthquake or makes more difficult the emergency response is negative. Seismic information is neutral. Here, you can see some examples of topics classified into a specific polarity. I'm going to ask you to focus on the keywords, underline it. And these are the rules for the topic analysis. So the name of the topics are self-explanatory, and the rules still explain a bit more. I'm going to give you some seconds to read it. Now, I'm going to give you some examples of comments from GlassQuega users classified into a specific topic. Intensity, for instance, distress, and seismic information. Now, solidarity messages, emergency response, and building damages. You can focus on the underlying words that give you the idea why they were selected. It's important to say that a topic or a comment can have more than one polarity or more than one topic. So that's why the classification can be done at tweet or comment level or a sentence level. In this case, the classification is at comment level. This is about tsunami, injuries and casualties, preparedness, and about governance and urban facilities. Now, so far the classification rules and the analysis have been done by experts in earthquake recognizing and disaster management. The idea is to discuss the rules and the result of the analysis with the stakeholders. That's why last year I took the opportunity that there was a conference in Tirana, in Albania, and in that conference there was native speakers, there were locals from institutions in Albania and people from USGS, and I asked them to classify the comment that you are reading into a polarity at comment level. That was the result, and as I said before, for me this is a radical production. Now, I asked them to classify the comment into a specific polarity, but at sentence level. Those are the results. Also, I asked them to classify the comment into a specific polarity at comment level. This is the result. And I asked them again to classify the comment at a specific into a specific topic, but at sentence level. So, again, that's for me co-production, and I'm going to, that's also applies for recovery cases. This is for the case of L'Aquila, that the 10th anniversary was in that date, and I see that I can also extract information. I'm going to ask you to help me with the classification of one tweet. This is the rules, so everything that contributes to recovery is positive, everything that delays the recovery is negative. Seismic information and invitation to commemoration ceremonies are considered neutral. So these are the rules, are very similar to emergency response with the difference that there are topics like funding and early recovery. And I'm gonna ask you to read this tweet. I'm gonna give you again anyway copies as well. And I'm gonna ask you to scan this code for those who want to participate. You can also go to Menti and introduce that code or use that. And I'm going to still distribute the some of these the tweets, because sometimes you cannot see it. And in the meanwhile, I need to go to scale. So the tweet is already in the Mentimeter, but unfortunately it's not possible to read it properly. And thank you. Now, you can do it at sentence level. You can notice that there are, each sentence has a different polarity. And now at topic level. Topic level at comment level, topic analysis at comment level. Only one topic.
sentence level. Can do the classification at sentence level.
So please consider all the topics that this tweet is addressing. And yeah, I'll finish with the exercise. It will be still open. So just to tell you that, just to stop, this is all the case studies that I have data for emergency response, for recovery. And these are the publications so far, the data sets that we have published, all the references. And thank you.